Are the Chicago Bears a team that can compete in the NFL at a high level now that they have drafted Justin Fields out of Ohio State? Or rather, are they a team that can compete to win in the NFC North, right? They play against Green Bay, they play against Minnesota, and they play against Detroit, right? Like, those are the three teams they got to beat out to win their division. Can they do this now that they have drafted Justin Fields as their quarterback? When I think of quarterbacks, I think of leaders, right? I think of leaders because, you know, from a young age, from Pop Warner to middle school to high school to college football, and if you make it to the NFL, all the way through, the overriding theme is, right, if you're a quarterback, you're a leader on your team. You are taught this from a kid all the way on up, right? Along with the quarterback position comes responsibilities of being a leader. And there's a difference between being super talented and being a leader. And you need them both to be an elite quarterback in the NFL. There's a difference between being talented and being a leader, right? Just two different worlds, right? We see several talented quarterbacks come and go, but they don't have those leadership qualities where, you know, they know how to get the very best out of those around them, right? People are like honeypots. And if you don't know how to engage them properly, right, you don't know how to tap into them correctly, you'll never get all the honey out of them, right? Like, that's just how leadership works, right? There are certain leaders in the business world, right, that can come along and take over a failing company and with the same staff and the same product, totally turn the company around because they just have that it factor and they know how to engage people and they know how to get the very best out of people, right? And quarterbacks like Joe Montana did this, right? Quarterbacks like Tom Brady did this, right? John Elway did this. They were really good. And when you watched their teams, everyone on the team, even the field goal kicker, the punter, all of a sudden everyone started playing good because they know how to hold everyone accountable to a higher standard and they know how to draw it out of everyone. And it's a whole different talent, right? It's a whole different talent than being physically talented, right? There's a mental aspect to this. When I think of Justin Fields, I see a quarterback that has both, right? I see a quarterback that is super talented, and I see a quarterback that also has leadership skills. I see someone with the potential who down the road could win an MVP in the NFL. Like, he has these qualities, Justin Fields. Keep in mind, in college, he was one of the major influences on why there was even a season, right? He was willing to stand up, take charge, you know, and fight for this, right? Because he has those qualities. He's not just physically talented, he's mentally gifted too, right? And you need them both to succeed in today's NFL. You know, I heard a stat the other day that since 1993, the Green Bay Packers have had 6 starting quarterbacks and the Bears have had 32. Now, I didn't look this stat up, but I'm pretty sure it's being embellished, right? Because there's probably some years where the starting quarterback gets injured, a backup comes in for 2 games, and then that counts as a quarterback. But even if it's just 70% of that, or half, even if it's half of 32, let's say it's 16. They've had 16 starting quarterbacks since 1993. That's still not all that great. Like, that's not good at all. Like, it's safe to say that the Chicago Bears have had a quarterback problem, right? And you hear different Bear fans, right, you know, say that our greatest quarterback was Sid Luckman. Like, you got to go all the way back to, like, way back, right? You hear other Bear fans say, no, it's Jim McMahon, right, the 85 Bears. And then you hear others say, no, it's Jay Cutler, right? You know, none of those quarterbacks threw for 4,000 yards. Jay Cutler did it once in his career, but he did it when he was playing for the Denver Broncos. He never did it for the Chicago Bears. Like, that's insane when you really think about it, right? Especially in today's NFL. Like, in today's NFL, today's a passing league. Things have changed, right? Like, Joe Montana never once in his career threw for more than 4,000 yards. Not one time. That's crazy, right? When you think about Joe Montana and what he accomplished as a quarterback in the NFL, knowing that not one time, not one season in his career did he throw for more than 4,000 yards. Because the NFL was different back then, right? It's a different league today. It just is, right? It's changed. Just like what you see happening in basketball with three-point shooting, right? Steph Curry has changed the game, right? It's normal to take half-court shots now. You didn't do that back in the day. But today, you know, back in the day you do that, you get benched. Today, right, you get a big paycheck. Like, things have changed. Well, things have changed in the NFL too, right? And it's a passing league. This is why you see defenses playing more, you know, nickel packages and dime packages, because they need more DBs to fill all the passing lanes. Things have changed. Well, the Bears finally have their quarterback, right? Justin Fields. Okay, I'm not going to quote his 2020 stats because it was a shortened season, but in 2019, he threw for 3,273 yards, 41 touchdowns, and only 3 interceptions, okay? Against Clemson this year, okay, he threw for 385 yards, 6 touchdowns, 1 interception. And keep in mind, right, this was in the playoffs against Trevor Lawrence, the quarterback that went number one, right? Like, he outplayed Trevor Lawrence head-to-head. Like, Justin Fields outplayed Trevor Lawrence head-to-head, and the Ohio State Buckeyes beat Clemson, right? You know, I did another segment where I talked about the 49ers, and they were going to make a mistake if they drafted Mac Jones. I said they should draft Trey Lance, right? And all the reporting was they were going to draft Mac Jones. And I said in that segment that if they're not going to draft Trey Lance, they should draft Justin Fields, right? Because I think Mac Jones is overrated. And I don't want to get into why, because I did another segment on that one too. But one point I have is 5 of the players he was playing with on offense, right? 1 running back and 4 wide receivers were all selected in the first round in either this draft or last year's draft. Like, that's a ton of talent to be playing with, right? 5 first rounders. Like, come on. But that's just one point. I have other points too. And I think Patriot fans are going to be let down with Mac Jones. I really do. I think Mac Jones in New England is going to be a letdown. But the reason why I bring this up is because if the 49ers were not going to take Trey Lance, I was okay with them taking Justin Fields. Like, I can accept an argument where someone would say, no. Trey Lance is not as good as Justin Fields. And you could build a great argument. Like, I could respect that argument. I personally like Trey Lance better, but I could hear an argument that no, Justin Fields is better. And I would respect that argument. I don't think it's outlandish or it's crazy to say something like this. You know, you could make a sound argument that Justin Fields was the second best quarterback in this draft. You know, and there was a time you could make an argument he was the best quarterback in the draft, right? I don't agree with that. Like, to me, Trevor Lawrence is the real deal. He's a generational quarterback. But man, Justin Fields, when he's on, like when he's on, the fact that he's a dual threat in today's NFL, you know, he's super talented and he has the leadership qualities and he has a high football IQ, you know, and I never bought into the idea that, oh, he takes too long to read into his progressions. That's just ridiculous. That's why you go to the NFL, right? That's why you take a step up, because that's a coach's job. That's what coaches do. They coach you up, right? I don't buy that just because he couldn't read through his progressions in the NFL, or excuse me, in college football quick, that he's not going to be able to do it in the NFL, right? I don't even like that argument, period. I don't like that argument at all. But the bottom line is the Bears have their quarterback. The Chicago Bears have their quarterback, and Chicago Bear fans have a reason to be happy. And also in the draft, right, the Bears did the right thing. They're thinking about protecting their quarterback. They drafted Teven Jenkins, right, probably going to start at right tackle out of Oklahoma State in the second round. They drafted Larry Borom, another tackle out of Missouri, probably be a reserve, could potentially fight for a starting position. Right? Like, they drafted Daz Newsome, a wide receiver out of North Carolina, probably going to play slot receiver. Like, they're building around him and they're doing it right. Now, when you look at the Bears defense last season, the final numbers aren't that good, right? They were 16th against the run. They were 12th against the pass. They were 29th in blitz percentage. They were 19th in QB knockdowns. They were 17th in QB sacks. These are not good numbers. Like, these are not good numbers. And when you look at the defensive players on this Bears team, you know that they are better than their numbers indicate, right? They have Khalil Mack, of course. They have Roquan Smith, Akeem Hicks, right? They just signed Desmond Trufant. Like, this Bears defense is better than those numbers. We know this, but I brought this up earlier. When the morale is down, when the team is down, right? When there's problems with the quarterback and you're not winning, right? You could just tell. Like when you watched the wild card playoff game against the Saints, right? It was a close game in the first half. But it was almost like the Bears defense was just like tired, man. Like the offense couldn't do anything. And you could just tell in the second half, it was just like, man. Like, you know, they go in, they stop the Saints, and then they watch the Bears offense come out and do nothing. They go and they stop the Saints, you know, and they watch the Bears offense do nothing. Like that's hard to rally behind. That's hard to build momentum off of, right? So you know the Bears defense is going to be better next year. You know the Bears defense is going to be better next year. So I wouldn't be too worried about those numbers just because of the names they have on this defense, right? The Bears defense has always been known for being a solid defense. They'll be fine next year. And I can tell you right now, they're already excited. There is already momentum being built, right? They're already excited. They saw the Bears trade up, you know, nine positions, right? And yeah, it cost them a first round pick. And yeah, it cost them some other picks, right? Multiple picks. But they saw management, you know, Coach Matt Nagy and Ryan Pace make a move, you know, because they know they needed to address it, right? And that's motivating in itself. So I'm not too worried about the Bears defense, right? And when you look at their offense, right, you have David Montgomery. Last year, he finished fifth in rushing yards, right? And they picked him up in the third round. Then you have Allen Robinson, right? Had an excellent year. And then they have Allen Robinson, right? Had an excellent year, finished in the top 10 in receiving yards, you know, over 1,200 yards, six touchdowns. They have Darnell Mooney, right? Like this offense is in a good place, right? Cole Kmet, the tight end, like this offense is in a good place. So this Bears team, right? You know, they're on the right track. They're on the right track. I, you know, this is one of those divisions again, where like, if you twist my arm now, I'm still going to say it's the Green Bay Packers, right? But who knows, right? Because there are reports now, that Aaron Rodgers may not return to the Green Bay Packers. If this happens, man, to me, if this happens, this division is wide open to the Bears, right? Because I think the Bears are better than Detroit. I think the Bears, yeah, Minnesota can be, you know, I think the Bears are better than Minnesota. I think the Bears, you know, if you put them side by side, I think the Bears are better than Minnesota, right? So if Aaron Rodgers leaves the Packers, right, and they got to go to Jordan Love, I mean, this division could be wide open for the Bears. But the point is, the Bears have their quarterback now. The Bears have pieces in place. You may not make a whole lot of noise this year because I could see them sitting Justin Fields for a year, but I won't be shocked. I won't be shocked if they play him. You know, maybe they use Andy Dalton, you know, for a few games, you know, try and get through the first five games and then they bring him in or something like that. But who knows? In today's NFL, I won't be surprised if he's starting game one. You just never know in today's NFL. But the Bears are definitely, you know, they're on the right track. The Bears are on the right track. Hey everyone, thank you for watching SP Sports today. Please don't forget to click the subscribe button down below. This way you are notified when we post new videos. Also, if you have a moment, leave a comment and check out our other videos.